Just wait, just wait, just wait, just wait. I'll free you. This is what to do to see what this is. Thank you.
I'm not sure. ഞാനത് പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. കൊണ്ട് പണി വിളിച്ചിട്ട് പോകാൻ വരാൻ പറ്റില്ല. കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞ വീട്ടിൽ ഞാൻ ഫോൺ ചെയ്തത്
the town taken from us. We hear that heartbeat, we hear that heartbeat. In the wind we hear their laughter, in the rain we see their tears. We hear their heartbeat, we hear their hearts beat. Night hangs like a prisoner, stretched over black and blue. We hear their heartbeat, we hear their hearts beat. In the trees our sons stand naked, through the walls our daughters cry. We see their tears in the rainfall.
hammer, people and friends used in World War I. This two-man generator used at that time required a lot of muscle for proper operation. Here are some of the tools used in those days. Compare them with the modern tools doing the same job today. First infantry pack was adopted by our army back in 1924. These recently captured German radios are a far cry from the early American models we've just seen, and a lot better. This Jap model is also compact and well-engineered and does an excellent job. But why shouldn't it? Almost every base, even down to the labels of the tubes, copied from our equipment. Now let's take a look at what our own radios are. They've turned out a set that tops them all, the SAR-694. It's compact, rugged and built, in a way every modulated radio telephone and radio telegraph. It's for communication between moving vehicles, as well as those that are stationary. We'll be right back. is operated within the carrying bag. All you have to do is take off the set cover and make proper connections. That completes the equipment as it is used to be. For vehicular installation, additional items are required, such as special mask tape, mask bracket, mounting for the mask, and of course, the special waterproof heavy-duty vibrator power supply. We'll be right back. with the modern group for doing the same job today. First infantry pack was adopted by our army back in 1924. These recently captured German radios are a far cry from the early American models we've just seen, and a lot better. This Jack model is also compact and well-engineered and does an excellent job. But why shouldn't it? Almost every phase, even down to the labels on the tube, was copied from our equipment. Now let's take a look at what our own radio engineers have been doing. They've turned out a set that tops them all, the SDR-694. It's a compact, ruggedly built, two-way, amplitude modulated radio telephone and radio telegraph unit. It's for communication between moving vehicles, as well as those that are stationary. And it's also designed for fixed station operation, as well as portable use in the field. All the equipment weighs about 108 pounds, and can be handled by two men in a pinch. The whole set is thoroughly waterproof and fungi-proof. Hey, what are you doing? Oh, I forgot. The transmitter and receiver are housed in a case that actually floats. Now, let's get that receiver and transmitter back in place. We can now learn a little more about the set. It is dry as a bone. Frequency range of the SDR-694 is from 3800 to 6500 kilohertz. Transmit and receive voice modulated signal, MCW or modulated continuous wave, and CW or continuous wave signal. A turn of the switch is all that's necessary. The power output range is from 8.5 watts to 25 watts on CW, and from less than 1 watt to 7 watts on both, depending on the position of the low, medium, high switch. And whether the hand generator or vibrator power supply is used. Here it's the generator because this is a field installation. The vibrator power supply is used for vehicular operation. Distance range of the SDR-694 is 15 miles on voice and 30 miles on CW between moving vehicles, increasing to much greater distances between fixed stations. Special horizontal antenna which goes with the set. Let's take a closer look at the SDR-694 and its component parts. Four canvas bags carry the set and all its equipment. As you install, they weigh about 108 pounds and thin can be handled by two men. These bags are certainly made to withstand rugged fields. The antenna equipment roll takes care of the mast section for the whip antenna. The metal stake for securing antenna guy rope. Generator legs and sheath. Planks for the generator. The insulator that is used in the field for the vertical antenna. And the power cable used for connecting the generator and the set. A second bag carries the operating accessories, which include the following. The headset, teeth, lip and hand mic, horizontal antenna, counter poise, and the gyro. Another bag carries the generator, and the remaining one, the set itself. For field installations, the set is operated within the carrying bag. All you have to do is take off the set cover and make proper connections. That completes the equipment as it is used in the field. For vehicular installations, additional items are supplied. such as a special mass base, mass bracket, mounting for the set, and of course the special waterproof heavy-duty vibrator power supply. Some of the tubes used in those days. Compare them with the modern tubes doing the same job today. The first infantry pack set was adopted by our army back in 1924. These recently captured German radios are a far cry from the early American models we've just seen, and a lot better. This Jap model is also compact and well-engineered and does an excellent job. But why shouldn't it? Almost every phase of it, even down to the labels on the tube, was copied from our equipment. Now let's take a look at what our own radio engineers have been doing. They've turned out a set that tops them all, the SGR-694. It's a compact, ruggedly built, two-way amplitude-modulated radio telephone and radio telegraph unit. It's for communication between moving vehicles, as well as those that are stationary. And it's also designed for fixed station operation, as well as portable use in the field. All the equipment weighs about 108 pounds, and can be handled by two men in a pinch. The whole set is thoroughly waterproof and fungi-proof. Hey, what are you doing? Oh, I forgot. The transmitter and receiver are housed in a case that actually floats. Now, let's get that receiver and transmitter back in place. We can now learn a little more about the set. It's as dry as a bone. Frequency range of the SGR-694 is from 3,800 to 6,500 kilocycles. It transmits and receives voice-modulated signals, MCW, or modulated continuous waves, and CW, or continuous wave signals. A turn of the switch is all it's necessary. The power output range is from 8.5 watts to 45 watts on CW, and from less than 1 watt to 7 watts on both, depending on the position of the low, medium, high switch. And whether the hand generator or vibrator power supply is used. Here is the generator because this is a field installation. The vibrator power supply is used for vehicular operation. Distance range of the SGR-694 is 15 miles on voice and 30 miles on CW.